In this video, we are going to know about saturation temperature, which is an important term in HVAC. Saturation temperature is the temperature at which a liquid starts to turn into a vapor. This saturation temperature varies with pressure. For example, when water is heated, once its temperature reaches 100 degrees Celsius, it starts boiling and changes from liquid to vapor. This 100 degrees Celsius temperature is the saturation temperature of water. The temperature at which a liquid starts boiling and changes from liquid state to vapor state is saturation temperature. Let's know what this saturation temperature is used for in the HVAC system. HVAC system contains a lot of refrigerants. Each refrigerant has its own saturation temperature. For example, the saturation temperature of R22 refrigerant is 21 degrees Celsius at 121 psi pressure. That is, if R22 refrigerant is heated to 21 degrees Celsius at a pressure of 121 psi, the refrigerant will begin to boil and change from liquid to vapor. We have said that saturation temperature changes with pressure. For example, we have said that if water is heated to 100 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure, it will start boiling. But when water is heated in a pressure cooker, the pressure inside the cooker increases. It will reach up to 15 psi higher than the normal atmospheric pressure. That is almost 2 atmospheric pressure. When water is heated at this pressure, water does not boil at 100 degrees Celsius. Water starts boiling only when heated up to 121 degrees Celsius. That is, when the pressure increases, the boiling temperature or saturation temperature of water also increases. At higher altitudes above sea level, atmospheric pressure is lower. The city of Manali in India is 2050 meters above sea level. Atmospheric pressure at these places is lower than the normal atmospheric pressure. When water is heated at these places, water starts boiling at 92 degrees Celsius. That means, when pressure decreases, boiling temperature or saturation temperature also decreases. The same concept is for refrigerant also. As the pressure increases, the saturation temperature of the refrigerant also increases. The saturation temperature of refrigerant is helpful in detecting the value of superheat and subcooling. Superheat equals current temperature minus saturation temperature. Subcooling equals saturation temperature minus current temperature. We have already explained in a video of superheat and subcooling, compressor can only compress vapor and cannot compress liquid. If the refrigerant enters the compressor in liquid form, it will damage the compressor. If the R22 refrigerant inside the indoor unit is at a pressure of 70 psi, its saturation temperature will be 5.5 degrees Celsius. So, if we heat the indoor unit to 5.5 degrees Celsius, the R22 refrigerant starts boiling and turns into vapor. Temperature above 5.5 degrees Celsius is superheat temperature. If we give 10 degrees Celsius heat in indoor unit, superheat value is current temperature 10 degrees Celsius minus saturation temperature 5.5 degrees Celsius equals 4.5 degrees Celsius. So, when it goes inside the compressor, the refrigerant goes only in vapor state. When the refrigerant goes inside the expansion valve, it should only go in liquid form. Only then we can get proper cooling. If the R22 refrigerant inside the outdoor unit is at a pressure of 225 psi, its saturation temperature will be 43 degrees Celsius. If we cool the outdoor unit to 30 degrees Celsius, then the subcooling value is saturation temperature 43 degrees Celsius minus current temperature 30 degrees Celsius equals 13 degrees Celsius. So, if we cool the refrigerant below 43 degrees Celsius in the outdoor unit, all the refrigerant turns into liquid state. If the temperature of a refrigerant is above the saturation temperature, the refrigerant is in the vapor state. If it is below saturation temperature, the refrigerant is in liquid state. If it is equal to saturation temperature, the refrigerant is in both liquid and vapor states. This is the detailed explanation of saturation temperature. If there is any doubt in this video, please ask in the comments section. If this video was useful, please like the video and share this video with your friends too. Please support and subscribe to our Zebra Learnings channel. Thank you.